In this video, we're going over the superficial view. It's going to be some outside structures, and I'll point and explain what they do. So the first one is going to be the cerebellum. So we're going to go ahead and turn the brain over. The cerebellum is number 35. It's also this large brown portion. And I have a whole brain just to kind of show you guys some differences between the two. So compared to just the single half, the sagittal cut, and the whole brain. So this is going to be the cerebellum. We know that this is responsible for balance coordination, muscle tone, and your textbook's going to go a lot more in depth, but for this, just this exam, those two major categories, coordination and muscle tone, are priority objects to learn. So we're going to go ahead and flip it over. And of this portion of the skull, oops, sorry, the skull of the brain, let me actually rotate to the side here. You're going to see the, we're going to focus on the frontal lobe. So the frontal lobe, we know, is right here. And on the side, that includes this portion right here, the frontal lobe. Just like where the frontal bone used to sit, right? And we know the frontal lobe is responsible for motor output, problem solving, and your unique personality quirks. So let's go ahead and rotate to this portion. So you're going to find the parietal lobe. Now, remember when we looked at the brain, right? We would see the frontal lobe, the parietal lobe, and then we would have the occipital here in the back, right above the cerebellum. So the parietal lobe, we know that's responsible for sensory input, and it holds your sensory cortex, right? So we'll move next to the occipital, and we know occipital is responsible for vision. And occipital is going to be here in the back, just to kind of show you. Portion 3. So 3 was going to be occipital, 2 was going to be parietal, and 1 was going to be frontal. So this occipital lobe, this is where visual input, or you know, the visual cortex. And next we're going to move to the temporal lobe. The temporal lobe is right through here. It's divided from the parietal by this nice little sulcus. So that's going to be the temporal lobe. It's responsible for auditory input, or home of the auditory cortex. Next, we're going to go to the central sulcus. So we're going to do a couple sulci. So when we're looking at the parietal half, we notice that the sulcus runs through here. This is the central sulcus. And it separates the frontal from the parietal lobes. Next, we're going to have the precentral gyrus. So the precentral gyrus, if you notice, remember, the gyrus was the like that bump, that swell, like that results from a sulci forming, right? So this is going to be the precentral. Well, it's letting you know it's right before that central sulcus, so therefore it's pre, number 6. And then 7 is, by the way, so just location in regard and some information about it. So the precentral gyrus right here, it's our primary motor cortex, right? So this is where we're housing a lot of our motor information. And 7 is going to be the postcentral gyrus. And this is where a lot of our primary sensory motor, primary sensory cortex, hello Annie, is going to be housed. Okay, so motor, sensory, and remember we talked about the parietal lobe being the home of the sensory cortex, and the frontal being the home of the motor cortex. Motor output. So we're going to go next to the lateral sulcus. So we're going to go ahead. So the lateral sulcus, again, a lot of these major sulci are going to be separating lobes. So we have this separation. This is the lateral sulcus of the temporal from the parietal. And by the way, you're going to have it on both portions, right? Because remember, the brains are mirrors of each other when it comes to these lobes. And next, we're going to have the transverse fissure. So we know this fissure is between the cerebellum and the occipital lobe. So we're going to go ahead and rotate this a little bit. So the brain's upside down, my bad. But still the best way to see it. So this is going to be that transverse fissure, okay? It's separating the cerebellum from the occipital lobe.